Hello folks, I thought it was about time to do a quick tour of the plot. This will only be a short episode, 10 or 15 minutes, so I just thought I'd give you an update to see, let you know what's going on. Okay, let's go.
That's the empty trough of sweet candle carrots. It's the first one I've pulled up, as you saw a bit earlier on. I've still got a couple more troughs left of those, and they seem to be growing quite happily. That there's just old rhubarb leaves, and that I'll need to chop up and get them into the compost bin later on. Looking on the, because of the soil's coming away from the carrots there, I might top those up a bit later on. There seem to be some fairly decent sized carrots underneath. A bit of kale there, sweet peas, and a few leftover bedding plants. I topped a few buckets up. These are the ones which were growing the first early potatoes. The rhubarb's still massive. Here's my celery. That's the Latham self-blanching. That seems to be doing quite well. The thing with celery, because it's like a semi-bog plant, you need to keep the water well down to the roots and that, so I do water these regular. Just put your end there, the sweet corn. You see there's a few actual corns appearing, the tassels on. And I don't know if I'm going to get too much, the sun's in, I'll move around this way. So a lot of them now have got actually the cobs appearing, and I do give the stems a shake just to move the pollen down to them every now and again. Over there is the parsnips. They had a slow start, but they seem to be picking up. And in between there we have the swedes, and I think there's some radishes in between in there somewhere. I need to get in there and sort that out. These are the peas, which I think these are calved and wonder, and we have been picking off these. They were slow, but they're starting to fill out now. I've had to put these strings over in the bags because I keep getting wood pigeons resting on the top, just flattening the tops and pecking the green off. So put the scares on, and they seem to have done the trick. So there's a couple of more rows here, them calved and wonder screen shaft as well. Down the middle there we have some beetroot. I think that'll be up ready for harvesting. And just move around to the brassica cage. If you can see inside the brassica cage here, the cage is 3 feet high, and these are the savoys. They're absolutely romping away. And next door to them is the sprouts. Got a few weeds in there, but I'm actually hitting the top of the net now, so I think I'm going to have to do a bit of modification to this, and also get some stakes into the sprouts as well. I've still got a few more round-head cabbages to pick. As you saw earlier on, we had five nice ones, and there's probably about another five or six left. Also, I've got a couple of greyhound in here. And them there at the back are the red cabbages. So they're actually romping along all massive. Since I put this white net over, the stuff seems to have just raced along in there, and very, very healthy and thick. I'm very pleased with it. The second planting of the calabrese also went to seed, so I think that's a write-off for this year. I do need to lift the roof of this net cage though, because the sprouts now are starting to bend over, and also on this I'll put some stakes in with them as well. Afterthought, what I thought was going to be a total disaster. There's one or two onions started to bulk up, which takes the sour edge off what was looking not to be too good with these onions, but there's one or two filling out now, so hopefully I'll get a couple out there. These are bunches of spring onions, white Lisbon these are, with some iceberg lettuce. And then I've got the French beans opera, which seem to be perking up now. I can see one or two beans on there, and in between there's a few rows of radishes and some beetroot. The outdoor cucumber, these are market moor, have started to kick out a bit of fruit now, and some of them have got two and three. These outdoor tomatoes are Alicante, and they've started to put plenty of fruit on now. This bed area is where the first early potatoes have come out. I'm still not sure what I'm going to put in yet. I've got a few winter brassicas to put somewhere, so maybe I might pop them in there. Just looking at the potatoes now, all of these are Sar Palmyra. And as you can see, the mosaics are sunflowers. They have started to collapse in the middle due to the weight in there. So I'm not sure. I might nip the tops down of the foliage yet, I don't know. One or two flowers are starting to appear. The beans are starting to move up the canes now. I'll just move down to the bottom of the trench so the sun's not in the camera. And we have, there is one or two beans starting to form on these. These are the Cabra beans, French beans. Now to the other side, I just notice you can see a runner bean on there, so they're ready now. I have nipped the tops out of most of these. Just one or two cherries left on now. That one looks a bit lonely on its own, so I'll just have that. Moving into the greenhouse, all the tomatoes seem to be doing okay now. Still plenty of fruit on, but nothing ripened yet. There's a sunbat, but I just noticed there we've got one just turning colour. Next door we have the Super Sweet 100. Plenty of fruit, nothing turned yet. So I've stopped these two plants out at the top at about 5 foot. Next one is the Roma, the Italian tomato. That seems to be growing all over the show, but again, nothing to shout right home about. And on the very end was the one I did replace because I nipped the top out by accident. That was a Mandurio, I think it's called, and that's grown, but it's very, very spindly stem. So I don't know why that is. Next door we've got the melons growing quite well. Got one or two flowers appearing on there now. It's grown up. And then we have the wall of cucumbers at the back. We've had lots and lots. We've had about six cucumbers off already, and there's still lots of fruit appearing. This one on the end is the Burpless Tasty Green. And you can see there's plenty of fruit on there. I've just trained the canes back up along the roof apex, and them all joining up together there. The middle ones are the Market Moor. Again, there's fruit on there, and the next door one as well. the end there, we've got another, that's another Burpleys. And so they are growing quite well. And I'm feeding these quite regularly with comfrey as well. And that's another melon in the corner. That doesn't seem to be so vigorous. And I can't see any flowers on that at the moment. The peppers, more or less a disaster. The aphids caught them earlier on, and although I sprayed them, it doesn't seem to have done much good. Although they're still growing, the leaves are all withered. And I noticed Bill off Ulster Allotment said that someone is some stuff of his, and good looking getting rid of them, mate. So that's about the greenhouse wrapped up. Tomatoes the other side, plenty on. These are big boy, and plenty of fruits on there, nice size, but no colour turning yet. Next door we have Alicante. And this one here is Gardener's Delight. You can tell that from the fruit truss off them. And the one right on the end is the old Ailsa Craig. So, tomatoes got plenty of fruit on, but nothing seems to be turning yet. So that's the tour of the greenhouse. The apple tree Egremont russet is absolutely plastered with fruit, and there's quite a few gone off with the June drop, but there's still lots and lots of fruit on it. I'm considering even thinning them out even more. Pear tree's got a little bit of fruit on, but nothing much. That's still better than it did last year. And there's one or two here got looks like canker appearing on the fruits. The sweet williams have sadly passed the best, and now they're starting to go over. On our apple varieties are absolutely plastered with apples. It's just unbelievable, the crop on there. Well, that's about it, folks, for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for coming around the plot with us. Thank you to all the subscribers and everyone with comments, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye for now.